Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for that. So, yes. And I should start to say that the study that I'm about to present is done in collaboration with Paul Henrik Due from Sweco Copenhagen, and or Sweco in Denmark. And so you're just sitting there doing nothing, and I'm up here doing all the hard work. But I thought that maybe you could help me on that. So your task is, whenever I do like this, then you switch to the next. But don't start yet. Don't start yet. Because I'll introduce you with this. Imagine that your FM organization has a new building project. Lots of money is spent on this brand new building of yours. Here's the once in a FM lifetime opportunity to get the perfect building that you and your core business deserve. Perfect brand new building for easy operation and easy maintenance, perfectly sustainable, and perfect to support your core business in any possible way. This is brilliant. This building, this new building, will take your FM organization to the very next level of FM. But maybe somewhere in the back of your mind, you remember sitting at one of these FM conferences or reading an FM journal or even taking an FM course. You remember now that you've heard that even brand new buildings are causing FM difficulties. Wouldn't it then be nice to know which difficulties? And wouldn't it also be nice to have an idea of which difficulties are most common, or you can say which pitfalls are most common in new buildings? And that's exactly the question that Paul Henrik Due and I asked ourselves. And by consulting the literature, we found important research on different difficulties. We found studies on the well-known energy performance gap, and we found studies showing that it can be difficult for FM to control and maintain a proper indoor climate, even in brand new buildings, just to mention a few difficulties. But we were looking for kind of the broader picture, a bigger picture of difficulties, and furthermore, we were also looking for a sort of top 10 most common FM difficulties in new buildings. We decided to ask FM practitioners in new buildings in Denmark, and to do so, we designed a web-based questionnaire. Our idea was to pose a number of difficulties and get the respondents to indicate on a scale to which degree they had experienced the posed difficulty in their new building. And to get started formulating these difficulties, we consulted the literature again. And we identified five categories of difficulties, and we also found a number of different difficulties which were too few in numbers to form an actual group, so they were in this other categories, and that ended up being a very mixed category. In each category, we formulated 5 to 7 concrete difficulties. So, for example, regarding indoor climate, a difficulty could be too cold or too noisy, and we formulated 21 difficulties, and then we asked a group of FM practitioners to give us feedback on these difficulties. And based on their feedback, some new difficulties were added, and some were split. Some were even split in 3 difficulties, and that added up to 35 difficulties, which we included in the questionnaire. Background questions were limited to 2, which is definitely something that we would consider to do different if we were to do it again, but there were only 2 background questions. And finally, we gave the respondents the opportunity to add more difficulties in each category if they felt that we have left some important difficulties out. Well, before we go to the results, I would like to say a few words about the 2 background questions and about the respondents. The intended population were FM practitioners in new buildings in Denmark. And the first background question was exactly about that, and it was, are you employed in an FM organization which has a building less than 5 years of age or a rebuilt building? And 76 of the respondents answered yes. Further, 29 respondents answered no. Because of the very limited background questions, we know only very little or almost nothing about these 29 respondents who answered no, and therefore we did not include them in the results. So the results are based on 76 respondents. The second and final background question was about their job description, and from the answers we can see that the majority of the 76 respondents are managing one or more FM disciplines, only a very few are on a kind of an operational level. And this is of course something to keep in mind when you hear the results. To fulfill the aim of, or our intention of ranking these difficulties from the least to the most frequently experienced, we calculated the mean value of the respondent's indication on a Likert scale of each of the 35 difficulties. We then organized it by the mean value. And you can find the entire list of the 35 difficulties ranked in order by mean value in our paper, and it has the same title as the presentation, so it's super easy to find. Please do that. Because I'll only mention a few here. And the way we did interpret it is that difficulties with the highest mean value nearest or closest to 4 experienced to a higher degree are the most frequently experienced and thereby the bad or the ugly. And difficulties with the lowest mean value nearest 1 never experienced are the least frequently experienced difficulties and thereby the good. And that's a very simple analysis of the results. It could have been done in a million other ways, but that's the way we did it. Okay, so here comes the good. Ranked as number 35, 34, and 33 are 3 difficulties related to architecture and layout of core business space. The optimistic interpretation of this is, of course, that this is something that we are really good at. And thinking or taking into consideration that support of our core business is probably your number one motivation for constructing this new building. That is great news. A more pessimistic or perhaps also realistic interpretation could be that most facilities managers, even on the high managerial level of our respondents, are most likely to have a technical background. We know that from other studies in Denmark. And perhaps architecture and layout or design of indoor space is just something that they are not that occupied with or that they pay less attention to. And well, maybe it's just kind of fine, but we don't know if that's the reasoning behind that. Next is automatic control of lights. We have enough of that, thank you. And unexpected need for double operation due to delay, to our surprise, not often experienced by our respondents. And poor physical FM working conditions, our respondents don't experience much of that in their new buildings also, and that is also super good news. Moving up to the most frequently experienced difficulties, you find 3 difficulties related to poor indoor climate: too hot, too cold, and poor control. Well, poor indoor climate, we were not surprised to find it among top 10 most experienced difficulties. In fact, we were surprised not to find it within the 5 top most frequently experienced difficulties. And this was also the category, indoor climate was also the category where the respondents had filled in most new or added most difficulties that we didn't come up with in the beginning. Difficult window cleaning is number 4 most experienced difficulty. And moving or pushing expenses from the building project to the operational phase is next. And finally, we have damage to doors and windows when forced open. And that could easily be closely related to indoor climate as well. We then move to what we have called the ugly, and meaning those with the highest mean value. On top 1 and 3, is difficulties in getting the needed digital documentation from the building project to FM. First one was about operation and maintenance documentation, and the third was about drawings or models, it could also be, but drawings. This was surprising to us, and I think that we both, in this and future conferences, will pay a little more attention to presentation on that topic. We finish with the second most frequently experienced difficulty, at least according to our respondents, which is unexpected high energy consumptions due to the lack of commissioning of technical installation. And this is not what, at least not in my opinion, not what we usually mean when we talk about the energy performance gap. This is more a peak consumption right after handover. And it's recognized to some degree in the literature as well, but I still consider this to be a somewhat overlooked problem, especially when discussing green architecture or green buildings. And finding it as the second most experienced difficulty in new buildings in Denmark shows that it's definitely worth investigating further. So there's no more. So we have now a bigger picture of FM difficulties in new buildings in Denmark. And we also have an indication of which of these difficulties are most and least often experienced. But our study perhaps raises more questions than it answers. For example, our study doesn't show which difficulties are then the most important to prevent and important for whom. It also doesn't show causes or consequences, and nor does it suggest possible ways to prevent these difficulties. So what are the results good for? Well, if I were in an FM organization with a new building project ahead, I would definitely go through the list of the 35 difficulties, and I would evaluate if I had done enough in my new project to prevent these difficulties to appear in my new building. Thank you.